in this video, we'll solve a gate question. So this question is related to first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics for an open system. So first law of thermodynamics for an open system. So the open system may be undergoing a steady state process or it may be undergoing unsteady state process. So many students will face difficulty in solving the problems which are belonging to this unsteady state process undergone by an open system. So in this video, we'll see how to solve a problem. So when it's from unsteady state. So before going to the problem, first let us see how to write energy balance equation and mass balance equation. So for a control volume. So here, so I am considering a control volume. So this is the control volume. So this is control volume. So a fluid stream is entering this control volume and a fluid stream is coming out of this control volume. Coming out from here. So this section I am calling it as section 1 and this section I am calling it as section 2. So the rate at which the fluid is entering, I am assuming it is M1 dot, and the rate at which the fluid is coming out from the control volume, I am assuming it is M2 dot. So M1 dot is the rate at which the fluid is entering the control volume and M2 dot is the rate at which fluid is coming out from the control volume. And apart from this, so there may be some energy interactions like heat and work. I am assuming I am supplying some heat to the control volume. So the rate at which I am supplying heat to the control volume, I am assuming it is Q dot. And this control volume is producing some work. I am assuming the rate at which this control volume is producing work is W dot. So W dot is nothing but dW by dt and Q dot is nothing but dQ by dt. M1 dot is dM1 by dt. So flow rates, it's per unit time. And apart from this, you can see here. So here, the fluid stream is entering the control volume. The fluid stream which is entering the control volume, it will have some amount of energy. So I am assuming E1 is the specific energy of that particular flowing fluid. And here, so E2 is the specific energy possessed by the fluid that is coming out from the control volume. So if you look at the fluid here, this E1 includes so enthalpy of this particular fluid stream, so kinetic energy of this particular fluid stream and potential energy of this particular fluid stream. The fluid may be having some potential energy, kinetic energy and some internal energy and some pressure energy as the fluid is flowing. So here, so first if I write mass balance equation, it is like this. So rate of change of mass of this control volume is nothing but mass entering the control volume and the rate at which mass is leaving the control volume. So this gives you the rate at which the mass is getting accumulated inside the control volume. Similarly, if I write energy conservation equation, so I write like this. So rate of change of energy of this control volume is nothing but energy entering the control volume minus energy leaving the control volume. If you look at the energies that are entering into the control volume, so a fluid stream is entering the control volume and there is some energy associated with this fluid stream plus some amount of heat is supplied to this control volume minus energy is leaving the control volume. If you look at the energies leaving the control volume, a fluid stream is coming out from the control volume. So this is M2 dot, is the rate at which the fluid stream is coming out. And the specific energy possessed by this fluid stream is E2. And apart from this, so there is some work output that's coming out from the control volume. So this is the work output. So this is the energy balance equation. So if I try to expand this equation, it is like this. So rate of change of energy of control volume. So rate of change of energy of control volume is equal to a fluid stream is entering the control volume. And if you look at the energies possessed by this particular fluid stream, so it will have some internal energy and it will have some pressure energy. And these together, I am writing it as enthalpy, H1. H1 plus it may be having some kinetic energy per unit mass and potential energy per unit mass. And this is the mass flow rate. So this is the rate at which energy is entering, so due to fluid stream. And apart from this, we are supplying some amount of heat. This is Q dot. Minus, so M2 dot into energy possessed by the fluid stream here is H2 plus, so kinetic energy of the fluid stream, potential energy of the fluid stream per unit mass. And so some control volume work is also coming out. So minus. So this is the energy balance equation. So this is how we write the energy balance equation. If you look at the question is like this. This question was asked in GATE 2008 mechanical paper for 2 marks. If you look at the question, a rigid insulated tank is initially evacuated. The tank is connected with a supply line through which air passes at 1 megapascal 350 degrees C. A valve connected with the supply line is opened and the tank is charged with air until final pressure inside the tank reaches to 1 megapascal. The final temperature inside the tank will be, the options are given. So, is greater than 350 degrees C, is less than 350 degrees C, is equal to 350 degrees C. Option D, may be greater than or less than or equal to 350 degrees C, depending upon volume of the tank. So, this is the given question. So, he is saying that, so there is a supply line and there is some air flowing in this supply line. There is some air flowing in this supply line. Air is flowing in this supply line. And he is saying that, so this air has a pressure of 1 megapascal. So, pressure of this air is 1 megapascal and temperature of this air is given as initial temperature. I am assuming it is P1 and T1. So, it is given as some, so 350 degrees C. So, this is the air flowing. So, this pipe is connected to a tank. This supply line is connected to some tank like this. And this tank is having a valve which can be opened and closed. So, he is saying that the tank is insulated. The tank is insulated. And initially, the tank is evacuated. So, there is nothing present inside this tank. The tank is insulated and the tank is evacuated initially. And if the valve is open, the air which is passing in the supply line will rush into this tank and fill the tank. Now the tank is filled. Now the pressure in the tank and the pressure in the supply line is equal to 1 megapascal. Once the air is filled inside the tank, so what will be the final temperature of air that is present inside the tank? This is the question. So here in this question, he didn't ask exactly the final temperature, what will be the final temperature. But he gave options like this. Will be greater than or less than initial temperature. So by common sense, just by looking at the question, you can answer this question. No need to put a pen or pen to solve this problem. Why? Because you can see here, a fluid stream is flowing here. A fluid stream is flowing here. You can see this fluid stream, this air, is having a temperature of 350 degrees C. The temperature is 350 degrees C. The air is flowing here. So it has a temperature of 350 degrees C. It means that it has an internal energy corresponding to 350 degrees C. And apart from that, so the air is flowing. So it means that it has some pressure energy. It has some internal energy, it has some pressure energy. We call it as flow work. It's flowing. So the air has some temperature and internal energy. Temperature is corresponding to internal energy. And the air is flowing, it has some flow work or pressure energy. So when this valve is opened, so this air will rush into this tank. Once the air rushes into the tank, so it cannot move anywhere. So once it gets settled inside the tank. So now it's not flowing, it's not moving, it's filled inside the tank. Earlier it was having internal energy and pressure energy. Now once it is filled into the tank, so it doesn't have any pressure energy. Why? Because it's not flowing. So it means that, so whatever the pressure energy or the flow work the fluid was possessing earlier, when it was flowing through the pipe, is converted into internal energy. As the molecules rush into this room, the molecules will be hitting to the walls and the molecules will be hitting among themselves. And as a result of this, all the pressure energy possessed by these molecules will get converted into internal energy. As a result of this, temperature of air will increase. Just by looking at the question, you can say temperature will increase. So when the fluid was flowing through the pipe, it was having two energies, internal energy and pressure energy. Once the fluid entered the tank, so there is no more pressure energy, it has only internal energy. So where has this pressure energy gone? The pressure energy got converted into internal energy and temperature of the air increases. So temperature of the air that is present inside the tank will be greater than 350 degrees C. So if you want to find out exactly the temperature, so you need to go for this analysis. So I am assuming this tank is my control volume. This tank is my control volume. If you look at that control volume, mass is entering the control volume, but no mass is leaving the control volume. Or energy is entering the control volume, but no energy is leaving the control volume. So it's a kind of unsteady state process. So here, so this is how you need to do energy balance and mass balance for an unsteady state process. So here, if you look at this control volume, so mass is entering the control volume. The rate at which mass is entering the control volume, I am assuming it is m1 dot. Since no mass is leaving the control volume, I mean, so this m2 dot is zero. So this quantity m2 dot becomes zero. It means that this entire quantity is zero. And we are not extracting any work from this control volume. Therefore, this quantity also becomes zero. Since the tank is insulated, there is no heat transfer happening. So this is also zero. In the question, he didn't mention anything about this velocity or this potential gradient. So these two things will be zero. I can say like this. Rate of change of internal energy of the control volume is m1 dot into h1. I can say energy of the control volume is just changing because of the fluid that is entering the control volume. So if you want to simplify further, so it is like this. So change in energy of control volume. Change in energy of control volume is m1 dot h1 into dt. So if I integrate this, if I integrate this, I can write like this. This is E2 minus E1. E2 minus E1 is, so if you look at this h1, h1 is enthalpy of the fluid that is flowing inside the pipe. So it's exactly same as the enthalpy of the fluid that is entering inside into the tank. So I can say h1 is constant. Since h1 is constant, I can write like this. It is m1 dot into dt. You can further simplify this. So m1 dot, you can see, m1 dot is nothing but the rate at which the fluid is entering into the control volume, and dt is the time taken so to fill the tank. So it means that, so integral m1 dot into dt use the total amount of mass that is accumulated inside the tank during this time. So I can write like this. This is h1 into m. M is mass of the air that has entered the tank. So it's nothing but E2 minus E1. E2 is energy of the control volume after the process, and E1 is energy of the control volume before the process has happened. And you can see the question, in the question he is saying that initially the tank is evacuated. Since the tank is evacuated initially, so there is no energy initially for the control volume. Therefore, I can write like this. Final energy of the control volume is nothing but H1 into M. So final energy of the control volume, it means the internal energy of the control volume, I can write like this. So final mass into Cv into the final temperature of air inside the tank. And this H I can write like this, H1, I can write it as Cp times T1 into M. So from here I can write like this. So final temperature of air that is present inside the tank is nothing but Cp by Cv is gamma times T1. So temperature of air inside the tank will be gamma times T1. And for air, gamma is 1.4. So it's 1.4 times the initial temperature. So obviously it will be more than, 40% more than the inlet temperature. That's 350 degrees C.